give a brief introduction about yourself, like what is your name and what is the name of your university and the course you are pursuing and the country that you belong to?
So, as you know, my name is Ashwin Palaniappan Ramani, and I'm from Chennai, which is like the southern part of India. It's like in Tamil Nadu, and I've done my bachelor's there. Like, I did my whole schooling there. I did it in St. John's, and then I did my B.Tech in SRM for Mechatronics Engineering. After that, I worked in IT for a couple of years, and then I decided to do my master's. So I moved to Canada and I did my master's on Mechatronics Engineering at Simon Fraser University. So that's in Surrey and it's in Burnaby. We have a branch in Vancouver as well. Like we are spread throughout British Columbia and Canada.
All right.
Simon Fraser University that's pretty popular for like masters, and like there's a lot of Indian students studying here. Yeah, so that's a bit about my background and my university.
Okay. So, can you provide some insight about the application process? Like, did you give any competitive exam, or did you submit any documents like SOP, LOR, or essays for the admission process?
Yeah, like every university has like a similar process. Like whether it is USA or Canada, they'll ask you to give letter of recommendations and LOR. I mean, an SOP, like an SFU, they didn't ask for. They don't ask for SOP per se, but they will ask for like a letter saying why you want to join the course. That is similar to your SOP. They don't call it the SOP though. That's the only difference. So I just wrote a single page and submitted them that like why I'm interested in joining that particular course. And yeah, that was the process for me. I applied for several other schools as well, and I submitted according to their needs. Like for example, some universities will ask for like a statement of purpose. That can be even 2 pages, that can be even 3 pages. But when the university is like, when SFU specifically asked me just for a 1-page letter asking why I wanted to join, and I just gave them that and some letters from my HOD and like from my work.
Okay. So were there any competitive exams for the admission?
There are no competitive exams, like as in like GRE is not mandatory for my university. But I have taken GRE too, like so I submitted that. It's like an optional thing. They'll give you like a form to submit, like a web form, and it has options like if you can submit a GRE score, you can, but it's not like mandatory. I would have gotten even without the GRE, because like all my friends, like few of them, they didn't take GRE at all. Even IELTS is not like mandatory. If you have TOEFL, you can use that as well. Like one English exam is compulsory since it's in North America. You just have to take either IELTS or TOEFL. And then like the academic version, and then like GRE is not mandatory, but I got a good score, so I submitted that as well.
Okay. So and did you give any interview while taking admission, and like before applying to the university, how did you gather the information? Like did you talk to some seniors or consultants that recommended you to go to this university?
My case was a bit different. Like my family lives in the West Coast. Like they live down in USA, so they're pretty close from here. Like it's like few hours drive from here. So that was the reason why I came to SFU. Like I got admission like 2-3 other universities in Canada as well, but they're like in the East Coast, and one of them was in Alberta. And this is like just for the climate and also the proximity to my family. That's why I chose SFU. But like there were no interviews because my course was a professional course. Like this is, I had a like interview from another university, like that's called the Queen's University, that's in Victoria, that's also in Canada. But SFU did not have any interview for me.
Okay. And can you talk about your study life abroad? Like you can tell us about the facilities at your campus, like any libraries, research labs, or the gyms, etc.
Okay, so let me talk about like SFU in general, because SFU is huge. My campus is in Surrey, while the main campus is in Burnaby. My campus has like a lot of mechatronics labs. My course is mechatronics, so like we have like electrical lab, we have like the Kaiser Foundation, the robotics lab, we have all the like mech stuff. But the campus is not so huge. It's like it's pretty small compared to the main campus. The main campus is very huge. It has a very big library for like 4 floors, and like each floor they have a good book collection, and students can like borrow books for free. Like even after after I pass out, like right now I just graduated, and even for like the next year I can borrow books for free. Like SFU is pretty good with libraries, and also we have 4 or 5 coffee shops inside, then we have like a pub inside, we have like a lot of hiking places very close to the campus. Our campus is like the main campus is situated on the Burnaby Mountain, and it's a very beautiful place. So anywhere you go, you can just like walk around, you can take a hike, and you can go to beautiful spots, you can just like chill there. There's also a park in the campus, the main, I forgot the exact name of the park, it's very close to the main campus, and they call it like, and whatever like events happen, they put it there, like during summer though, like winters are pretty cold, like not super cold like Toronto, but somewhat cold, but they play movies in the projector in the park, and yeah, it's a fun university. Like if you are joining here in the main campus, then the campus life is all sorted.
That's great. So like, how is the study pressure and competition at your university? Like, have you made any peer groups that you get together with to study?
Mm-hmm. So this depends totally on your course and like what level you are in. Like, for example, master's is totally different from bachelor's. So according to my understanding, bachelor's would be more competitive and like more time consuming, like you'll have to put in more hours of work to get your assignments done. And master's is generally for international students, they have it somewhat like lightweighted, and you should be able to manage it if you studied in India like for so many years. Because like bachelor's, they'll have like more subjects, like they'll have like 4 courses a term. Master's will do just like 2 or 3 courses. So it's always the case in any university in Canada, like bachelor's is going to be harder if you're coming from your school directly. That'll be harder for even students in Canada. Like everybody tries to cope up in the first year and they get used to it. They get used to the pressure in the second year. That's how the cycle works. But for my degree, master's, it was not that hard. Like I was able to do all my assignments on time. I was able to score like decently. I got a 3.67 GPA. So I was able to get it without so much struggle. I don't think it'll be very hard for assignments, but yeah, peer groups are very necessary, because without like partners and like without team members, you can't do any projects. Here, the projects are not like single centered. Like it'll be mostly mm-hmm. a team project. Even if it's a simple lab thing, like even if it is like doable by a single person, they won't like have it that way. They will have like teamwork incorporated in whatever thing possible. So teamwork, forming like buddies, study buddies, that's all very important when it comes to studying abroad. Yeah.
Okay. So like, what are the co-curricular activities at your campus? Like any clubs or sports event? And are there any student bodies like place for the placements and other, and you can talk about other functions and fairs that happen at your campus?
Okay. So coming to sports, like SFU is pretty good in sports. Like my university, they have we have an indoor gym, and we have like an indoor swimming pool. We also have indoor volleyball courts and badminton courts like in the main campus. And then we also have a huge like football field. Like I've never seen such a huge field in any other campus in BC. That field is pretty huge. And you can go and play like soccer, or like if you play American football, like we have teams, like our university has teams in all the sports. If you're good enough and if you're interested, like you might get into the teams. Otherwise, you can just like play with friends for fun in the weekends, or like whenever you find time, whenever the ground is not occupied, anybody can go and play. That's as far as the sports goes. And other co-curricular activities, yeah, like since Canada especially has a lot of international students, there'll be a lot of groups, like it's called social groups. Like there'll be groups called communities, like global community or India. There's a Punjabi group in our campus, like in my campus, and there's like an Indian group, there's a Chinese group, like Asian group. There's lots of communities, right? So you can join anything you want. Like even I can join the Punjabi group, even though I'm not a Punjabi, they're not going to say no to me. It's like anybody can join any group. It's up to us, like if you want to participate. And they host like events like once a month. They give you free food. It's just for interacting, like finding buddies and all, like finding like-minded people. And these events are generally good, because when you come from India, like initially you don't have any good friends, like, and it's good to meet like-minded people, like in the same, you might be living in the same street and you wouldn't know each other. And it's through these events that you get to know people like that. So I would encourage every new student to participate in these activities. And also, when it comes to placement, placement is not like, I mean, it's I should talk for it like in from two points of view. Like there's something called co-op or like internship program. So many universities have this thing called co-op, especially for like all degrees, like more than 2 years or so, they have something called co-op. So this thing co-op is like an internship, and the university will help you get an internship. Like it's not like they'll find you and company and tell you like we have an interview for you with the company. That's not how it works. It's like you'll have to keep applying, and the university will have a portal for you. So okay. Like and the employers can see our profiles from there. So that is much easier and better than like you sending a mail or applying on the employer's website. Because like some like for say like UBC, SFU, all these universities have a good name. So once they see this organization and they see our profiles on it, there's a good chance you'll get an internship. But yeah, that's as far as the placement helping thing goes. Like once you're graduated and you need a full-time job, like it's mostly up to you. Like they have resources which will help you. Like you can schedule a meeting with like a placement coordinator, or you can schedule a meeting with someone who can help you with interviews and all. But they won't find you interviews. It's up to you to like apply and find an interview, like upgrade your skills. Yeah, okay. So that's far as you know.
So do the companies visit the campus to recruit students who have graduated?
Yeah, that's I mean, I wouldn't say companies visit like campus just to recruit students. But like companies, like few companies, very famous companies, they keep recruiting every year, right? They keep recruiting every term. So these kind of companies, they have tie-ups with SFU. They have tie-ups with almost every university in Canada. And like, for example, TELUS is like an internet provider here. They recruit from every college. They go to every college, every university, and they have job fairs. And they want more people to learn their technology and start working for them. So I know TELUS, and there's like several other like interesting, like even research companies also come to SFU. Like this actually a few, like every year we have two educational fairs, like one during August and one during, I don't remember the other month. So one is called the tech fair and the other is called just the job fair. So the tech fair is for like for people like me who are in mechatronics and who are into like robotics technology and stuff. This will have all the new companies, startups, which wants like young people to work on their team. So they'll come and advertise about their company, and they wouldn't like hire you right away. They'll just see if you are the right fit. They'll talk with you, and they'll even collect your resume if you like submit it online or even if you submit it on paper. And that's a good way to network and make connections for your future like job. And I have done that too. Like I've given my resume and such job first. I've got calls for interviews, but yeah, I didn't go with that thing because it's too far from here, and it's like, and it's a research type of job, which it's okay. Much harder than what I can do right now. So I did not take that up, but yeah, that's similar to placements here. Like you wouldn't have like a sole thing only for placement. It's mostly up to your interest. Like these fairs will be happening, and like we wouldn't even know that these are happening. You should be like on the hook, like trying to find out when does this happen, because all these fairs, they happen and they happen sometimes in Surrey campus, this happens sometimes in Burnaby campus. So you'll have to keep checking the website and like asking people like when is the fair, and if you're like keeping track of everything, then you can attend all these events. Because okay. Like yeah, sometimes you might be in the other campus and you wouldn't know where the fair is happening, and then it's gone. Like for the whole year you won't have any other event.
Okay
yeah.
Could you tell us about the student teacher ratio of your department and the teaching approach of the faculty there?
Yeah, the student ratio, I think it's changed recently, but when I joined it was like I think it was 18:1.
Okay,
that was the student teacher ratio in mechatronics. Like for bachelor's it would be like even what do you say, I think for bachelor's it is 18:1, and for overall it is 18:1 for the whole mechatronics department. And for master's it was even lesser, like the students would be lesser, like it would be 12:1 or something.
Okay.
Like my whole class, we had like 24 people. Like that's it for the whole year. Bachelor students, there'll be like 100 guys easily. Like compared to masters, it's just like 25% of bachelors. So yeah, that's the ratio.
Okay. And my last question for you would be, what tip or advice would you give to the students who are planning to apply to your university?
Apply to my university. Okay. So first tip would be like to decide like which department you want to join, and like to filter universities based on like the ranking. Like for example, SFU, like my university, it's very good for mechatronics. It's also very good for like big data and computer science courses. So if you're joining for these courses, like research about the department, see which all professors are taking what courses. And if you want to do thesis, like then I would suggest the students to write like emails to the professors who are like offering the thesis. So thesis is mostly merit based. And if you want to join on merit, like do a thesis, then you don't have to apply like the normal like course based programs. You'll have to contact the professor first and then do the application. So that would be my advice for thesis. And for non-thesis, I would ask them to just have like maintain a good GPA in India. And if they have work experience, it's much easier to find a job later in Canada. So, okay. So try to work for a couple of years and then like decide if you want to do a master's and move here. I would ask them to do that because like all the Canadian employers, they want work experience when they're planning to hire you. So that's going to be very handy when you work and get here.
Yeah. Okay, thank you so much, Ashwin, for your answers.
My pleasure. Thank you.